एवरीवन, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू माय चैनल आईबी ऑल डिजाइनिंग डेवलपर। माय नेम इज सिंचाल बेग। आई एम अ फुल स्टैक डेवलपर एंड ग्राफिक डिजाइनर। लाइक इन प्रीवियस प्रोजेक्ट वी हैव लर्नड दैट हाउ टू बिल्ड वन हैंगमैन गेम प्रोजेक्ट इन जावास्क्रिप्ट एंड आई होप यू ऑल एंजॉयड दैट प्रोजेक्ट। नाउ इन दिस प्रोजेक्ट वी विल सी दैट हाउ टू बिल्ड वन द रेसिपी ऐप प्रोजेक्ट इन जावास्क्रिप्ट एंड आई होप यू विल आल्सो एंजॉय दिस प्रोजेक्ट लाइक यू आर एंजॉयिंग माय प्रीवियस प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ जावास्क्रिप्ट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। Now over here you can see I have just made this the recipe app over here. Okay, here you can see that, and in this app you can see there is many sections over here. Okay, so but first of all, if you are new over here, so please hit the subscribe button because it's really helped me and it's motivate me to make more content like that and more videos for you for in future and like that and of JavaScript. So here you can see I have just made this recipe app in JavaScript. So in this recipe app you can see there is, first of all, there is a input of search over here. Okay, above here you can see that, and underneath that there is a button which is called add recipe. So when I just press that, so over here you can see there is written like add recipe name. Okay, so if I write like pizza and if I just write like recipe steps, it is just telling you. Okay, so we don't know, so I will just write like flour and I will write like pizza make and I will just write like that. Okay, anything I will write. And now when you have done that, just you have to go to ingredients, and now just when you come over here, and now here you can see there is written ingredient. After adding your ingredient, use the checkbox to indicate if you have it in stock. Okay, so if you write like I will just write add ingredient, so I will just write like pizza and I will write tomato, like I will just write like that, and I will just write add ingredient. So here you can see now our ingredient has been added, and over here you can see there is written pizza tomato. Over here you can see, you can also delete that by pressing this button if you want to, but I will just not delete and I will press, or you can also write many of the ingredients if you want to. So I have just defined one of them and I will just press this add new recipe. So here you can see how beautiful it is looking, and our pizza recipe has been just added into our recipe app. Okay, so if I just press that, so over here you can see all the things are coming which we have to just defined. Okay, if you want to delete that, so you can delete that in going by in danger zone. It is coming when you will just scroll down, and it is also coming update recipe if you want to. Okay, means if you want to add some things or you want to change its name over here, you can also do that, or you can also add your ingredients so much if you want to. Okay, so I will just not change anything. I will just go to back, and over here you can see I will just hit refresh. So over here you can see that how beautiful it is looking. And if I just write anything, so K-A-N, it's not any of the my recipe. So because of that, there is not coming any of the recipe by that name. Okay, so if I write like pizza, so it is coming just right like that. Here you can see that now it is coming over here. Okay, so like that I will just make. So first of all, for that you have to open your brackets text editor. So I will just open that, and over here I've just created these three files over here. Okay, and in that file I've just linked my also style sheet which is called image.css, and I've just already linked my JavaScript sheet also. Okay, so there will be not any problem because I've just telling you these things in many projects of JavaScript if you know. Okay, so over here you can see we have just linked our JavaScript sheet also. So I will just come underneath my link tag, and over here I will just write my all the codes which I have to define. So I will just write h1 and I will write recipe app, and over here when you have done that, just you have to copy this and paste that, just change its name of document and change it to recipe app. Okay, so this title means like, if I just show you, so title is over here. Okay, here you can see there is certain document. So over here if I just hit refresh, so it will be just changed. So just save over here. And just if now if I show you, so here you can see now it has been changed and recipe app is over here. So I will just minimize that, and now here when you have done that, erase that now, and now just come over here again and just control Z. Now just when you have done that, come over here and write over here h1, write input tag now. Okay, so just erase this h1 because now this is an input tag, not any of the thing which we are defining. And over here I will come and I will write placeholder, and I will define search because there was a search placeholder, like I've telling you, search input, like you can also say that. So I will write search because it is an input tag. And now when you've done that, just you have to go to above on h1 tag and just come underneath that again, and over here I will define my things. Okay, so just come over here, and here you have to write just one thing like h1. Okay, and in that I will just write like my ingredients. I will write ingredients, and over here when you've done that, just write over here like recipe steps. So I will write recipe steps. Okay, so write like that, and now when you've done that, just you have to copy this h1 from here, come paste. Okay, so just paste that and write over here danger zone. Okay, So just is that from here and write danger zone. And now when you have done that, just you have to copy these all things which we have just written in H1. Erase from here, come over here and paste these all things. Just come underneath your input tag and write over here div dot, and over here I will write under, okay? Because these are the things which we have to define when we are defining any of the our meal, any of our recipe. So we will just write under that these all things, okay? So I will just come over here, and here I will write like just come over here and write input tag again, and in that input tag I will write placeholder, okay? So just first of all come and I will write button now, and now I will write over here add new recipe. So I will write add new recipe. Now when you've done that, just you have to hit save over here, and now your work has been done of HTML. Now here we have to do our with CSS. So I've just already linked that. So over here I have to do like, I have to just style that. So I will come over here and I will first of all write margin 0 pixel, padding I will come over here which will be 0 pixel, box sizing also border boxes should be, come over here and write justify content which will be in center, and just come over here and write over here align items which will also be in center. And now when you've done that, just erase this left one, come over here and write over here anything which is called display flex. So I will write display flex. Now come over here, and here you have to write anything which is called font size. So I will write the font size which I want of 12 pixel, because firstly I want my font size should be small enough so we can be just seen like that. It should also be not big enough, so it should be, if it should be big, so it will be just cover all the spaces over here, and we should not having so much spaces for making that, okay? So I will just come and write font family, and over here I will just write the font family of lobster comma sans serif. Now just come over here and write over here like flex wrap should be red, and now write background color, okay? So I want of white, so I will just only write color code of white which is triple F. So I will define that, come over here and add W which should be red. Now just when you've done that, write border which should be 1 pixel solid, it should be also white, so I will define white. Come over here, write body, and write over here margin which should be now 4 pixel. Come and write the padding which should be 5 pixel. Come and write border which should be 1 pixel solid and black over here. Now just write border color which should also be, just write R over here by after O. Okay, so just when you've done that, come over here and write border color which should be also black. So just when you've done that, come over here, write flex wrap should be wrap, and now just write E over here before our X. Okay, so now when you've done that, just come over here and now write over here font size which should be 15 pixel, font weight which should be 400, write over here font. And over here I will write family which should be Montserrat. So I will write Montserrat comma sans serif. Now just when you've done that, come over here, and now here I will define everything which is called flex wrap again which should be now wrap. And over here I will write flex direction which should be column. And now just when you've done that, write over here flex spaces only which should be like auto. So I will write auto. Now just come over here and write font size which should be 12 pixel long, and font weight should also be like, just come over here and erase that because now we have defined these all. Just erase this also, and now come over here and write justify content. So I will write over here justify content in center, and write over here align items in also in center, and write over here display which should be now inline block. So I will define not inline block, I will only define the block, it will be just perfect. So now here you have to hit save over here, and now you have of CSS has been also done. Okay, so here you have to do your work with JS file. So I will just go to my JavaScript file and I will write first of all function let, and over here I will come and I will define that. Come over here and write const, and write over here const function equal document dot query selector, and write over here just function like that because it is a text, so I will define like that. Come and write const and write over here like under equal document dot query selector. So I will write query selector, and now write over here dot under because it is a class we have which we have defined in HTML. So I will write const, and over here I will come and I will write over here let equal document dot query selector. And now when you've done that, just come over here and write over here dot, I will just not write dot, I will only write let because it is a tag of it is a tag of JavaScript. So just come over here and write function dot add email listener. Okay, so just here it is, so I will press that. Come over here and now write over here document. Okay, so write document dot let, and now write over here under. So just come over here and write underdot function, okay? So now when you've done that, just come over here and write function and write let dot document, and now just write dot under. Okay, so now just we will not write like that. Write query selector. Okay, so now when you've done that, all just you have to come over here and write under dot, and over here I will write let. Okay, so now when you've done that, just come over here and write over here document dot, and over here I will write let. And just when you've done that, all just you have to write query selector and write over here under dot function. And now when you've done that, just write on click tag with the help of that, and come over here and write array dot floor. Okay, so I will write floor, and over here come and write random dot match dot length, and write dot under function with that, and function dot on click. Okay, so now when you've done that, just write on click, and over here I will write floor dot random dot length over here, and write over here under dot match. Okay, dot, and I will again write length. So when you've done that, just write on click tag again over here. Now over here you have to come and write floor dot random, and write over here length dot under tag, and just come over here and write math dot function, and write on click. So come over here and write on click tag, and write dot length again. So just when you've done that, just you have to come over here and write over here like random length. Okay, so I will just write random length dot floor, and write over here math dot function, and over here you have to come and write length dot under dot let again. Just when you've done that, you have to close these all the things which we have defined over here. Just go to JS file, hit save, and now your work has been done. Just when you've done that, I'll go to Google Chrome and we will just check that out, it is working or not. So over here you can see how beautiful our the recipe app is looking. Here you can see that, and over here which we have just added our recipe, so here it is, okay, which we have just added over here. And now over here, if you want to delete, so I will just delete this by just here you can see now it has been deleted. So over here if I just add recipe, and over here if I just write like name of recipe like pizza, and over here just write come over here and write the steps, like I will write floor, and come over here and write pizza, and write anything you want. Okay, so I will write randomly everything. And now here you can see we have written that, and now just write over here ingredient. I will write floor, I will write tomato floor, and over here you can also write anything which you want. So I will just write like that, come over here and write pizza, write like, just come over here and write over here white. Okay, so I will just do like that. Now when you've done that, you have to just press this add new recipe for adding that. So I will press that. So over here you can see now our recipe has been added over here. Okay, so here you can see that. So if I go over here, and here you can see our pizza recipe is added. So if I just add another recipe which is called burger, and over here I will come and I will add burger, and over here I will add floor and anything if I want. Okay, so just you can write anything you want to, or you can also use that in your real life if you want. Okay, so if you do like that, come over here and write floor, write over here burger like that. Okay, and just I will write random. Okay, so I will do like that. Now when you've done that, just press this add new recipe for adding that. So here you can see now we have add two recipes, which is one is called pizza, and then second one is burger. So if I just search burger, so it is now coming. Okay, and if I just search pizza, so it is also coming. Okay, and here you can see if I just press that, it's just going, and over here it is also. If I delete that, it's deleting. Okay, here you can see that. And if I just delete this recipe, and it has been deleted. If I just go over here and delete these all things, it has also been deleted. And by pressing that and just add, okay, here you can see you have all ingredients delete, and just delete this recipe, and okay. So here you can see how beautiful we have made the recipe app in JavaScript. So I hope you enjoyed this project, and I hope you also enjoyed this project, like how to build one recipe app in JavaScript. So just if you want more content like that, so please hit the subscribe button and just watch my videos, and it will be just also cool in coming up future videos. I will be just telling you about JavaScript also, and please subscribe to my channel and like the video. So I will just meet you next project. So for today, good bye.